Meditation time. Breathe in a really, really big breath. Hold it for 2 seconds and then breathe out. So breathe with me very slowly as we watch the leaves blow in the wind. Okay, I think we've breathed enough. It's time to do art. Hey art friends, it's Antonia again. And for today's art project, we are going to make a little spring-inspired creature, even though it's nowhere near spring. Well, it's near. So today you're going to need your scissors and some patterned paper and we're going to be using our clothespin and we're going to be using our puffballs. These puffballs and googly eyes. Okay, so, and then once again, glue, and I think that's about it. So gather your things and we're gonna start making our little creature. All right, you're grabbing your clothespin and your piece of paper. It's not very big, it's about the same, a little bit bigger than the clothespin, okay? I want you to cut your piece of paper so that it's as long as the clothespin all the way around, so a square. So let's do that right now. Okay. As you can see, it's not a perfect square. I'm known for not measuring things and making it perfect, okay? This is just a fun, wonky, organic shape. And that's okay. Okay. So this is going to be a little caterpillar on a leaf. So let's try to figure out how can we make a really nice leaf if we've never cut out the shape of a leaf before. Let's figure that out. Now we're gonna try and make the leaf maybe just a little bit smaller than the clothespin, okay? So watch this. Keeping the clothespin here, making it a little bit smaller. That works. Okay, now for the leaf shape. So you're gonna fold this over. You can fold it like this, or you can fold it like this, where it's like the corner to corner. You can fold it side to side or corner to corner, okay? Either one. I'm gonna fold it corner to corner. All right, it's folded. And now I'm going to draw, oh, I guess I didn't tell you we needed a drawing implement. Let's go do that, let's get that. I have my piece of paper and I have a pencil to draw. So we're gonna draw just one side of the leaf. It's gonna be great whenever we cut it. Okay, it doesn't have to be a perfect leaf. So watch this. It's just one side of the leaf, okay? So it's just like a kind of rounding off the paper. And we're gonna cut along here, okay? So let's get our scissors now. So here's the scissors and here's the paper that I drew the weird little rounded shape on, and we're about to cut. It's still folded, okay? Okay, so it looks like a taco, and now it's a leaf. And it might be a little bit big, so let's see. If it's a little big, it can kind of go off, or you can make it smaller. It's up to you, okay? But now I'm going to glue this, either side, it doesn't matter, they're the same. I'm gonna glue one side of the clothespin to my leaf, and that is the little landing pad for our caterpillar. So we're gonna make a caterpillar today, and then another day we'll make a butterfly. We're trying to get spring to come, okay? Trying to like think about spring, warm thoughts, colorful things. We want spring because it is very cold. Even in Texas, it's cold where I am. So let's try to get spring to come. I bet this leaf would look cute because, you know, caterpillars love to chew on leaves, okay? So what if we cut a little chew spot? Looks like a caterpillar chewed on it, right? And, you know, they always make holes in leaves, it's funny. So even, you could fold it over and make a little hole by cutting. Or if you still have a hole punch from the last time you did the art class, just punch a little hole right there. And it'll really look like, yes, the caterpillar has claimed the leaf because they love eating leaves. Okay, so now I'm gonna get my glue and I'm gonna put it on here. And it's pretty well spread on there, as you can see. If it's on this side, just kind of wipe it off. All right, and now we're gonna put this leaf on. I'm gonna put the chewed side towards the front. Okay. All right, we got our leaf. Now let's do the caterpillar. Of course, these are not glued on, okay? So grab a few of your puff balls. I have a few here. Oops, and they're falling. And it could be any color, and even if you want a multicolored caterpillar, you could do that too. Oops, I just lost my puffball. This is the fun part. Having too much fun. Okay. All right, so puffball of different colors. I think I'm just going to do a little yellow caterpillar, so bye puffballs. And now we're going to glue them on. So here's the leaf. I'm gonna put some glue on the leaf so that the puffballs can sit on it. This seems like plenty. I'll move my leaf over a little. It got off. Okay, there we go. Okay, puffball, and puffball. Do you think I should put one more on? I don't know. Sure, why not? Maybe make it a little curved, like kind of gives it some movement. Okay. All right. So far, so good. Now we're going to put some eyes on our little caterpillar. All right, so these are some different sized eyes. I'm not sure which one would look good. Let's experiment. I feel like these might just be a little too big. Yeah. I mean, you can do it. I'd love to see. If you really love the big eyes, you can do that. These are more medium-sized. That might work okay. But I think I'm going to go with the little beady eyes. Just seems to fit better. So let's try that. If I can squeeze it out. Doesn't want to come out. There we go. All right. One eye. Oop. And the other eye. Let's try to get that on there. Oh, what a silly, silly caterpillar. All right, so that caterpillar chewed on that leaf, and he's ready to devour all the leaves in the area so that it can turn into a butterfly. Oh, it's cute. It's a fun little caterpillar. You can make more than one. You can make friends for the caterpillar. You can make different colors, shapes, sizes, and just have fun with it. I'm excited to see your caterpillars. All right, and I wanted to show you another way to make it look like the caterpillar was chewing on a leaf is to just rip the paper, because that kind of makes it look like it was chewing, okay? So you can always do that too if you want that to be your leaf. Ripped paper. It makes it look more like a natural leaf. Okay. So I'm excited to see your caterpillar and where you put it. Maybe put it on your curtain at home or on your backpack. Of course, it'll probably fall off because it's kind of delicate. It's art. Or you could put it on a card for somebody for Valentine's Day. That'd be a nice little gift. A happy little Valentine. All right. Can't wait to see your art. Thanks for making art with me. Bye.